Приветствую вас снова на Запад X. Это 10-я практическая конференция по продвижению на западных рынках. Следующий доклад у нас на английском языке. Почему я советую его послушать? Когда мы говорим про какие-то масштабы по доменам, просто вдумайтесь. Калин трекает примерно 800 миллионов доменов, которые есть в их базе данных. То есть это то, что они проверяют, смотрят, что удалилось. У них очень много данных о том, что случается с доменами. И они владеют 300 тысячами доменов. 300 000, man, it's crazy.
Yes.
I thought it was like 3, right? Damn. So, в чем суть этих доменов? То есть, Калин, я думаю, вам расскажет, подскажет, поэтому слушайте внимательно, задавайте вопросы, я обязательно эти вопросы задам. Он приехал к нам из Болгарии, прямо вот на студию, поэтому начинаем. Let's go.
Hello. I'm Kalin. I manage two domains. It's a 30 people company dealing with domain names only. And we have the largest accessible database of domains in the world, both existing and expired. We also own a lot of domains, as you heard. Our sub-brand SEO.domains deals with domains with SEO value, so very good links, mostly used for PBNs. And it's the largest inventory of SEO domains where you can buy for fixed prices, so not losing time to bid in an auction. Today we're gonna talk about GTLDs and CCTLDs, so general domains versus country domains, and what are the differences, the pros and cons to using them as in a PBN context. So GTLDs, COM, network, or the global ones are 167 million total registered, and CCTLDs are about 150 million, so more or less the same quantity. There are some new GTLDs which have a lot of registrations but few websites, so we're gonna ignore them from now on. As you can see, GTLDs and CCTLDs are almost the same, have almost the same share of the pie of total registered domains, and also a similar quality, because it's domains after all, some are good, some are spam, some are held by domainers, so it's more or less a similar thing. So I'm gonna have two slides of annoying terminology, sorry about that, but then you'll understand the next thing better, and also if you have problems with domains, dealing with support and stuff, you'll be able to use the right words and solve your problems easier. So the registrant, that's you, the owner of the domain, and you get it from a provider, which is called a registrar, which is confusingly similar. But if you made a poor choice, basically, where to buy the domain, you can have a middleman called the reseller, which is not directly accredited, but just charges you more for being an extra proxy. And the registry, another surprisingly similar word, so that's very confusing, is the mothership that manages the extension, and usually don't deal directly with them unless there are some problems. So basically, when you buy a domain to use for PBN, the domain is pushed or transferred to you, and then you change your name servers, and then you have to renew the domain. What you don't have to do so often is change the ownership. If it's not publicly visible in the whois, you can avoid that. So this will be important in the future, that you don't always have to change the ownership of the domain you bought for a PBN. You can change the email, of course, so you can manage the domain, but the actual name behind the domain, you don't have to change it in most cases. And there's a very important word you need to remember if you manage domains, mostly CCTLDs, which is a contact or a handle, which is just a string of letters and numbers, which is used as an identifier in the systems of the registrar and the registry. So domains with the same registrant data are said to be tied to a handle. So this will make life easier for you if you get this concept. And GTLDs are much more used for PBNs than CCTLDs, and there are some reasons for this, but most of the reasons are actually myths. Some of them have a part true, but some of them are actually completely wrong. So we're gonna go through them, and the first one is that CCTLDs are more expensive, so that you buy for registration and for renewal, you pay more for CCTLDs than for .com network. Mostly this is due to using bad registrars that overcharge a lot, so bad choice of registrar, which is the number one problem with CCTLDs. And actually, if we look at the cost prices, So what the registrar pays to the registry, so this is the bottom lower price you can ever get the domain, so they then don't sell at a loss. If you look at this, you see that actually the most ccTLDs, the larger countries, UKD, RU and all the other big countries, they're actually cheaper, some are much cheaper than .com. And in this case, when you know these cost prices, which is some valuable information for you here on the slide, when you know the prices, you know how to negotiate with the registrar to give you a good price. So the cost price plus €1, plus €2 at most, if you have a lot of domains. If you have a lot of domains, you can do cost price plus some cents. So actually, this is more or less what you will pay, and it's cheaper than .com, both for registrations and for renewal. So the next myth, which has some historical context, is that it's a very popular one, is that you have to be a local resident to own a ccTLD. So people think that to own a .co.uk you have to be from the UK, and to own a Swedish domain you have to be Swedish, so you have to be like these fans here, they're not letting you in. And there's some historical truth about this. It used to be like this in many countries, but in reality, nowadays, most countries have freed themselves for it. So this is the actual data from our database, because we know how many domains are registered in each ccTLD. And about 80% have no requirements or extremely easy to bypass ones. 17% have some requirements that you do have to worry about. For example, .ca, you have to be Canadian, .eu, you have to have an address in the European Union. That's why a lot of UK domain holders of .eu are gonna lose their domains after Brexit if they don't do something sooner. Mostly it's not a problem, because registrars, they want to sell more domains, so they're giving you different options to have different data, not yours, sent to the registry, and then you can still own these domains. So there are three ways of doing this. One is local presence, so just some of the contacts, let's say the admin contact is from the registrar. Sometimes it's free, sometimes you have to pay a little extra when they actually own the domain for you. So the full registrant data is everything is the registrar's. It's called trustee service, so it's like a little heavier option. And you also have the option of outright cheating, which is often the best one. For example, if you want to register a .ca and you're not Canadian and you don't have any Canadian friends, you can just take some address in the internet from .ca. But beware, because in some countries there are checks and in some countries there are non-checks. So in .ca you can do it, but don't do it with .eu. .eu is better to pay €1 to the registrar and use their local presence. There are some countries in which outright cheating is the only way. So for example, in Australia, .com.au, if you try to use some trust your local presence, this is forbidden, so you risk a lot, and it's also quite expensive, but you can do outright cheating. So go to the business registry, take an ABN, Australian business number, which is what is they require for verification, and of course use a company with a similar name than the domain, and you're probably gonna survive, like 95% chance that the PBN will survive, which is worth it if you're doing something in the Australian market, as there's no other way. And there's a very small percentage, like 3%, that are really too hard. They need a local company with the name of the domain, which makes it harder to use Trusty, or they need something else. But there's a trend of liberalization in this area, so less and less of the ccTLDs actually require anything.
Льете на микрокредиты в USA? Open Market от Zero Parallel поможет отправить ваши лиды сразу в несколько партнерок, чтобы продать лид по максимальной цене на рынке. Дополнительные преимущества. Подробный анализ лидов, повторная монетизация, русскоязычный суппорт. Свяжитесь с нами в течение 7 дней и получите безлимитные пинги, выкуп уникальных непроданных лидов за $1, эксклюзивный дизайн CMS. Заходи на openmarket.zeroparallel.com. Пока вы смотрели этот ролик, мы обработали 430 лидов. Link Bro. Создание эффективных PBN под ключ под любые регионы. Написание текстов, поиск доменов, сетап сайтов, система управления, рекомендации по использованию и простановке ссылок. Только эффективные PBN на выходе. Используй системный процесс и наши наработки для достижения топ-1. Оставляй заявку на linkbro.net.
Надоело тратить время на поиски площадок для статей? Исполнители постоянно подводят с размещением? Коллаборатор – биржа прямой рекламы. Уникальные и качественные площадки. Отзывы рекламодателей. Гарантия от удаления. Низкая комиссия. Удобно размещать и статьи на англоязычных сайтах. IT, бизнес, финансы, игры и другие тематики. Количество площадок постоянно растет. Продвигайте свой бизнес вместе с коллаборатор.
Это Андрей. Он директор интернет-агентства по продаже авиабилетов. А это Аркадий, маркетинг-директор. И недавно они начали продвигать банковские услуги через интернет. И Марина, владелица женского онлайн-портала. Они классные ребята, но у них есть одна общая проблема – привлечь на сайт больше клиентов и, конечно же, увеличить продажи. Но так, чтобы не один раз, а постоянно. Перепробовав все платные способы рекламы, ребята поняли – без поискового продвижения сайта не обойтись. Ведь сайт без продвижения, что автомобиль без бензина. Вроде красивый, но толку от него мало. Смотрите, человек ищет в интернете именно то, что вы продаете, и вводит в Google или Яндекс свой запрос, а в ответ получает большой список сайтов. А теперь представьте, что ваш потенциальный клиент видит в топовых позициях не вашу компанию, а ваших конкурентов. Представили? Вот поэтому вам не обойтись без поискового продвижения и профессионального подхода. И вот как мы это делаем в SEO Profi. Сначала мы проанализируем ваш сайт, а также конкурентов. Затем подберем нужные поисковые запросы. Дальше проведем внутреннюю оптимизацию, а после этого займемся внешним продвижением. В итоге ваш сайт с каждым днем посещает все больше клиентов. Вы наблюдаете рост продаж, и вы зарабатываете больше денег. И самое главное, что в SEO Profi мы приводим вам не просто посетителей, а именно клиентов. Мы уже более 8 лет работаем на рынке продвижения и работаем с клиентами в США, Англии, Австралии, Канаде, Европе и СНГ. Продвинули более 500 сайтов, вывели в топ более 115 тысяч ключевых слов и привели на сайт нашего клиента 2,5 миллиона посетителей в сутки. Закажите бесплатную консультацию о том, как продвинуть именно ваш сайт в топ на сайте www.seoprofi.ua.
And the myth that has a bit of truth to it is that CCTLDs are too hard to manage. Just like in this picture of too many kids and one dog making a mess. It can feel like this when you're managing a lot of different extensions in different registrars. But especially, again, here the problem is that if you have bad registrars. And even worse, if you have reseller who buys from a bad registrar and you don't even have the contact with the bad registrar itself. So like there can be very tough situations where you cannot renew, transfer, do some change or do anything with your domains where it's crazy expensive. And there's a lot of frustration in many people that have been in such situations. But again, the reality is that it was basically your fault and lack of experience if choosing bad registrars. So in reality, the right registrars can handle it. Sometimes the right registrars are not the largest ones. You can have very small local registrars with very high quality service, very dedicated support because they're working on some small local market. For example, if you buy domains from Greece, just use Greek registrars. They will know everything about the ecosystem of .gr domains and everything is gonna work perfectly. You have support and everything because when they're on a smaller market, you're more important to them. So you're a valued customer. And another one that is related to SEO, not the domains, is that the CCTLDs only help you rank in the country where you bought them for. So of course, you shouldn't go overboard and like try to rank in US google.com with 100% co.uk domains. You know, that would be stupid. But you can use them in the mix, and if you don't have like directly conflicting countries like US, UK, or the German-speaking countries speaking the same language, where Google really must turn to the TLD and the links of the domain to determine where actually to rank the stuff. If you just use domains where there's no conflicting language, you can use anything. For example, you can use Greek domains in google.com and it will work. Maybe it won't have 100% of the effectiveness of .coms that were used in the US, but it will be like twice as cheaper. So overall, a much better option. And when you mix it, it's gonna be just part of the mix because you shouldn't use only PBNs anyway. And it's natural for websites for small countries to link to authority websites in bigger countries. So it's basically natural to link between countries. So you can use anything in the mix. It's not a problem that your domain is from some weird country. Actually, domains from weird countries are the best because they have no local market, so they're easier to catch. They are cheaper when you buy them, and they have strange stuff in the whois, so Google won't just bother to parse their unique, strange whois to get some data that may be a potential fingerprint, because it's just too small country and too few domains. And also, if you strictly want to use only US domains for the US, there are .co, .io and others that basically there's an official list of Google that some domains from some countries like .io is just a rock in the ocean. The country is British Indian Ocean Territory something. So you can use .io with no problem because it's not actually a country and Google will not try to rank you in Google.io. Google.io actually doesn't exist as a country, Google, so Google understands this as a world domain or US domain in the context of google.com if it had US backlinks. So going to the registrar part, the most important choice you have to make with ccTLDs apart from ngTLDs too, apart from which domains to buy, is where to buy, which registrar. I already said, and I'm gonna say it again, no resellers. Reseller is just a middleman who charges you extra money to being a proxy between you and the registrar, which is, you can only lose from this in terms of finance, in terms of problems. When there's a problem, you go back to the reseller, to the registrar, to the reseller back and to you, which is a nightmare. So you should use directly accredited registrars every time that it's possible. So I'm gonna mention first for gTLDs that NameSilo is the most liked one. We don't use it so much because we don't have a lot of gTLDs, but it's a very good choice with 100% positive reviews. Our personal favorite is Dynadot, which has good prices, also API and supports more TLDs. And something I like for each registrar I use, I know the boss. Like when you know the boss, you know that every problem, if it's just a matter of effort to solve it, you can solve it. And I also know that when the boss is decent, then the whole company is gonna have good values and will take care of your domains well. So the negative review, Namecheap, I don't like them, tons of problems historically with them. GoDaddy without the club is just like an upsells machine. So if you use GoDaddy, please use the domain discount club. Enom and Network Solutions are like the dinosaurs of the domain industry, very old registrars with not such a good service. And unfortunately, often when you buy domains from NameJet, they end up there, but that's life. So if you want to pile up most of your domains in one registrar, so you want to use for gTLDs and ccTLDs, there are a few good options. I know the owners of InternetBS, Name, ISP and Hexonet, all great companies. And with ccTLDs, it's not such a footprint when you have all your domains in the same registrar, and you'll see why later when we talk in detail about whois. There are also some registrars which they are like dinosaurs inside. They work mostly with resellers, so they have huge amounts of domain under management and everything is automated, like Open Provider, InternetX and RR Proxy, also known as Key Systems. And these you can use at least if you have 5,000 domains. If you have less than this, I wouldn't recommend it because they are made to be used not by people, but for APIs, for resellers, which do everything with an API. So you see bad panels, some easy tasks are not so easy there because of every domain being tied to a contact and all of this system, the contact and the handles I explained. So this is for really serious stuff. And you. Basically, if you use API to manage your domains, then it's worth it. Otherwise, it's not. And exotic TLD is my favorite, the ones that are easier and cheaper to get. Very good registrars are Netting, Subrec, also known as Grancy, Mr. Domain, also known as Dom Dominio, they're Spanish, and in WX, which are German. So these are very good to manage really weird TLDs. They have accreditations everywhere with a lot of registries, and they're basically very good. So we should stay away from very big European companies that are GoDaddy-like, so a lot of retail and upsells and not such good service and support. So like 123 Reg in the UK, 1&1 OVH, these are the ones I would recommend to stay away from. And also Instra and EuroDNS, we previously had problems with, although they are quite popular, so avoid them too. So GTLDs, they have the advantage that everything is standardized, everything is easy. Also, the dispute system is quite slow and expensive, so you don't get a lot of domains lost by a dispute. And the annoying thing is the transfers. That's a 60-day lock after registration is super annoying, and also some email verifications. CCTLDs are the other way around. Transfers are nice, often free without renewal, so you'll be able to basically toss the domains around like they were some kind of ball. That's very convenient, especially if you buy and sell domains. And they have the advantage that in some countries like UK, EU, B and others, you have a direct access to your account at the registry. So if the registry decides to completely fuck you up, you can still go directly to the registry, and then the registrar is fucked up because you bypass them as a proxy and you just change your registrar or do whatever you want. So the drawbacks, basically the technical side is the drawbacks of CCTLDs. Some countries have lower fees and easier dispute system, which you lose a bit more domains, but still we're talking about less than 1% problems here, so don't think that you lose like a significant portion of your domains. A very common problem that people are very annoyed by is that a lot of countries require, when you change the name servers, to already have a valid zone. So like if I have to translate this to a not so technical language, if you use cPanel, you have to add on you have to have the add-on domain already added before you change the name servers. Otherwise, it won't work. It won't accept the name server change. You need to have a valid DNS zone for the domain. If you have to change owner, basically you don't have to for PBNs because Whois is hidden after GDPR. But if you do have to change owner, you sell a domain or something, they are signing paper forms and other annoying stuff. But as I said, this is a rare thing. And the most annoying thing, everything is different in each CCTLD. That's the thing that most people hate, because when you don't know the registry, registrar, reseller system with the handles and everything, which is like the backbone of everything, of how domains work, then every CCTLD seems completely different and it's a pain. So you just have to build a small foundation of knowledge, and then you understand the peculiarities of each CCTLD. But this is manageable with the right registrar, of course. So Whois? Whois has two types of data about the domain and about the owner. So most Whois now look like this, thanks to GDPR. So thanks European Union. Now, thanks to you, there will be a lot more PBN spam, because everything is masked. You don't see anything basically in GTLDs and almost all CCTLDs. And for CCTLDs, golden rule, always be a physical person, because then you're more protected by GDPR, which is a privacy law, so it applies more strongly to physical persons than companies. And always be a real person, and if you know, which is easy to check with a random domain, if you know that your data in the Whois is not going to be public, just use your real name, real email and real everything, and then you don't have to fear any checks or losing the domain, as has happened to some people using fake data in CCTLDs. This is not a good idea, but it's not visible, so don't worry. So what does Google look for in Whois? Google has two approaches to checking Whois. And the approach for CCTLDs is they basically don't check anything. They just rely on domain tools, domaintools.com, to check everything and then include it into reverse Whois searches, which are used for reverse engineering PBNs. So basically CCTLD Whois Google outsources, but GTLDs are different because Google is ICANN registrar, so they have an easy channel to GTLD Whois. So they look at registrant data. Luckily after GDPR there's no more of this, so you don't have to buy privacy or anything. Even if Google looks, it's just empty. They look at registrars, so for GTLDs it's certainly not a good idea to have all your PBNs at the same registrars. And they look at creation date, so it gets devalued if the domain expires and creation date is reset, it gets a bit developed in gTODs. So that's the spectrum. Most ccTODs are perfect because Google doesn't know any whois and there's no whois to be taken by domain tools so that it can be included in the reverse whois that Google uses for reverse engineering PBNs. A small percent have whois due to some local law, so just they don't care about GDPR. And all the gTODs are almost as good as ccTODs, but not as much. So, to understand gTODs, you should understand that registrar can hold the domain, so this results in auctions. And this is what happens with the auctions. If it's GoDaddy, it goes to GoDaddy auctions. If it's in a big registrar like Tuco, Enom and others, it goes to NameJet. If it's a registrar with a small marketplace like Dynadot, it goes to Dynadot marketplace. And everything that's left over from all the auctions didn't get any bids, plus some other domains, they go into pending delete. Golden rule, if it goes into pending delete for 5 days, it always drops. Registrar doesn't have control anymore. So if it drops, it's reset, it goes to dropcatch.com. Again, there's an auction if it's a good domain with more than one bid, but the creation date is reset. So there's a very often asked question, auction or expired domains, which applies to gTOD only because this is determined by creation date from Google and Google checked creation date only for gTOD. So all ccTODs dropped or whatever have auction quality. That's just how it works technically. But with the gTODs, they are expired and it's a bit devalued. And this is already actually devalued, determined by case studies. Or auction domains, they work well, but the problem there is that Google can very easily assess the auction list. So we don't know how much they work as well, because it's extremely easy to get all the domains from GoDaddy auctions, NameJet, even the smallest marketplaces. So there can always be flag for the future to be checked for PBNs. So as a final conclusion, ccTODs have the advantage of creation date not being checked by Google. So you don't have to worry that they're expired and registered again. And there are no easily accessible lists by Google, which is very important for long-term safety. So it's better price, better safety versus some annoying detail. So I recommend going for the better price and safety in general. That's it. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much for interesting speech. Everybody is pretty impressed about 300,000 domains. You know, some people thought that it's like Blogspot domains or no, it's like ccTOD and it's like cost money, right?
Yeah.
The funniest question is like, how much is the fish? Where is the money? What's the ROI like about this? Like, I know like it's crazy to ask directly, but our like viewers pretty directly. You know.
So most of these 300,000 ccTODs are Swedish domains that we got at a very good promo, which mm-hmm. unfortunately won't happen again. So we won't renew most mm-hmm. of them. But we have tens of thousands of domains that we will renew. And yeah, the bill is pretty big. I don't wish anyone to have such a bill.
you think Swedish market is that big to like that you need 100,000 domains there?
It's just a matter of ROI. We got so cheap price that we basically registered
everything.
So cheap
price is like $1 for domain or
no,
less?
No. We are talking about less than 10 cents.
Wow.
So it was a guaranteed ROI with a 1 year operation. So and
yeah,
it was,
so even if you sell for $1 it's like good profit, right?
Yeah, but we focus on premiums and we sell for three figures. So like it's a lot of ROI.
Okay, cool. The question is, I'm trying to translate from Russian to English. But and it also was a fun question, can you speak Russian?
Well, a bit, I understand Russian, but cannot speak so well.
Okay, how many issues you get from like lawyers about brand name domains to your company?
We get a lot. Yeah, like we
a
get
lot is like 1%, 2%, 3%.
No, much less compared to the, we get on average, several cease and desist letters a week, which is not so much for our number of domains. And cease and desist letters, we give, if it's not some important domain, we give a standard answer. Mm-hmm. Like, because they want the domain, they are brand protection companies, and they have two types of of ways of working. Either the company behind the real brand, the big mm-hmm. brand, is okay to pay a little for the domain, mm-hmm. or not okay, like not negotiating with terrorists, like yeah. thing. So and you don't know in the beginning. So if you want to get some money for your domain, even though it's infringing, you can say, like, the domain is basically free, but the process of returning costs something.
Yeah.
Like 50 euro, 100 euro, whatever you're okay with getting. And because for them to make a dispute, an actual, to take away the domain costs usually 1,000 or something,
they
will actually pay the small money, and you just have to be stubborn and say, like, I'm not giving the domain for free. And
when you started to register your first domains, like when?
10 years ago.
Yeah, so it was like 2008, like we were talking yesterday that I started to register domain like almost the same time. Crazy, but you got to this big amount. What register offer trusty service for cheap price?
It depends on the extension. It's often a local one. So if it's some very strange country, you should go to the local ones. Mm-hmm. Especially if there's no big accredited ones.
Okay, when is MedDiggity recommends Namecheap for the Whois alternation option, and the cost is only 10 bucks per domain. Why they are not that good, like in your table?
Oh. They just have bad technology and bad support behind. So like they have cool brand and marketing, but the system behind is not good, and we have big problems with them previously.
You know they are as well from Ukraine. No, I'm kidding. But they are. Okay. The question is, I think it's fun one. Why people can't register email at mail.bg anymore?
Mail.bg? I don't know. I thought they were still functioning. I have a mail there, a very old one.
Okay. Where you can get cheap $1 domains?
Cheap $1 domains.
Not XYZ, but maybe some country one or like.
Like the country promos work the following way. The registry decides, okay, we're gonna do a promo, mm-hmm. and we wanna have a promo like all year round, but in different registrars. So each month they give to a different registrar a $1, £1, €1 promo. Mm-hmm. This is mostly you'll be able to get in this way .uk, mm-hmm. .ac, Swedish ones.
Like and UK is you can get for $1.
For £1, yes. Wow. If you, but only
you
a few months a year.
Hmm? But do you need trademark for to register that UK?
No, I meant Co UK, but UK too.
Yeah,
it's all the same.
Nice. Nice.
So Co UK, you have to find the right registrar that has the promo, and basically they will charge two to the mm-hmm. end customer, but you can negotiate or use reseller focused registrars.
Okay, thanks for answering. The question is from the chat, where do you take contacts data? Like, I mean, I remember yesterday you told me about that you register most of the domains on one company, but we used to register like one domain per one person, and this person usually fake, you know?
Yes, but after GDPR, this is not needed anymore, because it's not visible.
So you say like Google can't see anything.
No one can, actually. In CCTLDs, Google hasn't got any special advantage regarding CCTLDs. They are not CCTLD registrars.
Yeah, GDPR actually rocks, like you said.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
like really cool, because like for the like perspective, it's like a really cool feature that you can use. Okay, what language do you recommend to use on Greek PBN if my main money site is on Swedish?
So I would decide depending on whether you can easily restore a nice Greek website from Archifork or mm. not. So if you can, maybe just use the original Greek website, or if you can't, you can repurpose like in Swedish language and mm-hmm. your niche.
What about that option? Remember, like for example, if I'm if I have a Portuguese domain, like from your database, for example, I bought from you a Portuguese domain like with like 100 backlinks and good authority. Can I register that Brazil domain like on mm-hmm. The same like language Portuguese and redirect, but the name will be actually the same as Portuguese one. So will it work? Is it like common practice to do?
It's not common practice, but I do think it's a good idea because there are some countries like Brazil has an annoying auction system, so it's very hard to get domains. Mm-hmm. And there are some countries in which domains are very expensive to get from local auctions, like Germany, Netherlands, Scandinavian countries. It's extremely hard to get good domains for cheap.
Yeah, and usually in Swedish, like I know one guy from Malta, they register like for $200, like every domain, like they buy.
It's very expensive to get anything with decent links. So in this case, when the price starts going 2-3 times more, it's better to get a domain from a non-competitive country mm-hmm. and maybe redirect it to a local one with the same name. And if Google
the same brand name, for example, my website dot I don't know dot de, so we can redirect it to my website dot com, whatever. Yeah.
Well, you have ugly name dot dot gr, and then you buy ugly name dot se. And redirect, and then because it's the same name, Google should be perfectly fine with this redirect.
Should I
then you have a .sc link with power.
Mm-hmm. Should I go to Search Console and then like use this redirect to do it properly, or you just can redirect?
I'm not such a big expert on redirects. I guess you can test it both ways.
I know you're expert on catching. Right?
Yes, our main power is catching.
Catching. How long you've been developing this tool just to like to see all this domains?
The database we started 8 years ago.
Nice. And like you said that you monitor, do you have in your database like more than 800 million domains? It's basically all domains like
to have all domains that exist and that ever existed, but we have completed this to about 90%. But for SEO and PBN purposes, the ones we miss are the ones that don't have websites, links and anything. So for SEO purposes, like we have 99% of anything.
Nice. And how much do you spend on like Majestic just to scan like these domains? I don't know, once per year, it's like a lot.
For us it's easier because we know in which TLDs you can actually get good domains for cheap and we focus there. While for example we ignore .com, we ignore completely because it's too overcrowded.
Yeah, but how many you scan like for
More than 100 million for sure.
Yeah, so like 100 million domains is like a lot of data, and just Majestic.
Majestic is cheap. It's like £300 per month.
Yeah, so you just use basic API. It's enough, right?
Yeah, we use the the plan with the API.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Here's the question about the price. Okay, and to buy for cheap, you need to buy a lot, right? And to know when to buy, right? Or just...
For the ones with promos, you have to know when to buy from which registrar because it's hard to take track of all the promos. But you can always ask registries and registrars, you're a client of both, so you can always go to the registry and ask, hey, which registrar is doing a promo this month? Will there be any promos? You can also ask different registrars. Just ask, and because you're a customer and everyone is going to pay attention to you. Mm-hmm. So. And also, a good thing is that in each registry, you get a list of all the registrars. So if it's a small country and you cannot find where to register your domain, a good registrar, just go to the registry and all the registrars are there always in a public list. So that makes it easy.
Okay, thanks for answering. How can I register Brazilian and Argentina domains without real country business or person?
I recommend a company called Toweb, toweb.domains.
Toweb.domains.
Yeah, it's a very small company, but very good one.
Okay. How do you see your business in 5 years from now?
I hope to be shifting a bit away from SEO and into big data stuff. So mm-hmm. becoming like a search engine for domain and website metadata. But I also hope to be even stronger in drop catching because this will always be viable.
Yeah, because like it's crazy, like you can resell it almost immediately if somebody just forgot.
Also, traffic and premium domains are even more available than SEO. So,
yeah, cool. Thank you a lot for your speech and for answering the questions. Hope you will enjoy an after party, like to communicate with the guys.
Thank you too.
Мы переключаемся на русский язык. Калин, кстати, будет сегодня на автопати, с ним можно пообщаться. Поэтому те, кто будет на автопати, welcome, спрашивайте вопросы. Я думаю, это будет более чем полезно. Мы переготовимся к следующему докладу. Это Владимир Лучанинов. И правильно? Правильно. я всегда путаю на фамилии, как правильно говорить. Поэтому оставайтесь с нами, будет очень круто. Пару минут, мы снова в прямом эфире.
Льете на микрокредиты в USA? Open Market от Zero Parallel поможет отправить ваши лиды сразу в несколько партнерок, чтобы продать лид по максимальной цене на рынке. Дополнительные преимущества. Подробный анализ лидов, повторная монетизация, русскоязычный суппорт. Свяжитесь с нами в течение 7 дней и получите безлимитные пинги, выкуп уникальных непроданных лидов за $1, эксклюзивный дизайн CMS. Заходи на openmarket.zeroparallel.com. Пока вы смотрели этот ролик, мы обработали 430 лидов. LinkBro. Создание эффективных PBN под ключ под любые регионы. Написание текстов, поиск доменов, сетап сайтов, система управления, рекомендации по использованию и простановке ссылок. Только эффективные PBN на выходе. Используй системный процесс и наши наработки для достижения топ-1. Оставляй заявку на linkbro.net.
Надоело тратить время на поиски площадок для статей? Исполнители постоянно подводят с размещением? Коллаборатор – биржа прямой рекламы. Уникальные и качественные площадки. Отзывы рекламодателей. Гарантия от удаления. Низкая комиссия. Удобно размещать и статьи на англоязычных сайтах. IT, бизнес, финансы, игры и другие тематики. Количество площадок постоянно растет. Продвигайте свой бизнес вместе с Коллаборатор.
Это Андрей. Он директор интернет-агентства по продаже авиабилетов. А это Аркадий, маркетинг-директор. И недавно они начали продвигать банковские услуги через интернет. И Марина, владелица женского онлайн-портала. Они классные ребята, но у них есть одна общая проблема – привлечь на сайт больше клиентов и, конечно же, увеличить продажи. Но так, чтобы не один раз, а постоянно. Перепробовав все платные способы рекламы, ребята поняли – без поискового продвижения сайта не обойтись. Ведь сайт без продвижения – что автомобиль без бензина. Вроде красивый, но толку от него мало. Смотрите, человек ищет в интернете именно то, что вы продаете, и вводит в Google или Яндекс свой запрос, а в ответ получает большой список сайтов. А теперь представьте, что ваш потенциальный клиент видит в топовых позициях не вашу компанию, а ваших конкурентов. Представили? Вот поэтому вам не обойтись без поискового продвижения и профессионального подхода. И вот как мы это делаем в SEO Profi. Сначала мы проанализируем ваш сайт, а также конкурентов. Затем подберем нужные поисковые запросы. Дальше проведем внутреннюю оптимизацию, а после этого займемся внешним продвижением. В итоге ваш сайт с каждым днем посещает все больше клиентов. Вы наблюдаете рост продаж, и вы зарабатываете больше денег. И самое главное, что в SEO Profi мы приводим вам не просто посетителей, а именно клиентов. Мы уже более 8 лет работаем на рынке продвижения и работаем с клиентами в США, Англии, Австралии, Канаде, Европе и СНГ. Продвинули более 500 сайтов, вывели в топ более 115 тысяч ключевых слов и привели на сайт нашего клиента 2,5 миллиона посетителей в сутки. Закажите бесплатную консультацию о том, как продвинуть именно ваш сайт в топ на сайте www.seoprofi.ua.